Do you think you're inspiring?
No, I don't think so lah.
I don't know eh. I think
from my point of view, I try to be inspiring. Hopefully they feel inspired from what I think is inspirational. I don't know, that's a weird question.
I have never thought about that. Because I'm still an athlete.
I hope I'm an inspiration to others.
1 to 10, how will you rate yourself?
I'll put myself at 1. Because I like to think like there's a lot of things to improve.
5, because I thought that for now, I'm not at like my best form yet, so if I want to like work harder and like show others that I can still be better than that.
7 to 8. There are definitely some things I can work on in practice. Not a 10. No one's a 10.
6. 1 point we reserve for God. Then we have 3 more points to go. Yeah. So there's room for improvement. But you want to be positive, so you give yourself a pass mark, like above 5.
Earliest memory of her, probably like a toddler who is very timid and afraid of humans and who will hide behind the curtain whenever we have guests in the house, or she will cry when the grass mower comes round and mow the grass like maybe once a month or something like that. Quite fun, because the both of us are girls, but actually we don't exactly behave like girls. We are quite boyish when we play also.
Joseph very seldom cried, and he came late into our life, so he was very treasured, you know. He was a very lively baby. I love smelling him, because when he's young and a baby, it was just pure scent, you know. And you can smell this milky smell, you know. After swim, I take him for a shower, and I go with him into the shower to make sure that I wipe his toes, between his toes, so that he doesn't have eczema. One day I was wiping, I said, how to make this guy laugh? So I said, my goodness, no wonder you can swim so fast, son. He said, why, daddy? You got webbed between your toes. So he said, where, daddy? Where, daddy? You could see the pitch in his tone and the expression on his face. That will last me till I die.
When I gave birth to Farhan, it was okay. And Farhan came out at about 3.6 kilograms. Farhan has been always the studious. I don't need to worry about him. I think for Farhan, if he wants to do something, he would just want to go for it.
Actually, when she's born, I was inside the delivery room. And the first impression he gave me is that her eyes were so big looking at me.
The moment when I hold her, it was like so touching, you know. Wow, I never expect that I can give birth to such a beautiful baby. I don't know how to say, yeah. It's just very, very happy.
Well, she was very hyperactive. It's like swimming, table tennis.
Everything.
Everything. She would try out rollerblades.
As long as she's interested with that thing, she pick up very, very fast.
The one that made me really proud is that when she decided to, you know, continue on this journey and try for Tokyo 2020. It's not an easy decision to make. She's at an age where, you know, a lot of her peers are already on their career pathway, and some even getting married, having kids. At the same time, I also feel very fulfilling. I feel consoled that, you know, somebody is trying to achieve something that I couldn't continue doing. I think she's very inspiring.
When I left Joseph in Jacksonville, and I came back, I was very emotional, and I told May that my son will never be separated from me ever. I don't want to be the richest man in the cemetery. I just want to be with my son. I mean, like a 13-year-old or 14-year-old boy, of course they will cry when their parents leave or something. So the mother said, do you want to come back? He says, no, because the only way I can be good is to be in the United States. So not only we sacrifice, he also sacrifices, you know. Very filial son. Joseph doesn't have this I, me, myself syndrome. That's why I miss him so much, you know.
He is a role model, as you can say. My husband was saying, wow, you're already on par with me as world champion. Being a world champ at quite a young age is something that I think the rest of the kids in the Silat club or our Silat fraternity, they would like look up, oh, brother Farhan is the world champ and two times. I think if you train as hard as him, you also can be one of these days.
I'm proud of her is because during competition, she's very focused.
She never gives up.
This is the most important thing. She fight until the end. When she was at the podium receiving the medal, at that point of moment, we are so touched. Yeah, and so happy for her. She have such a result. We are really very proud of her. There's no words that can
describe
how happy we are.
Does he inspire? Of course he inspires. This is what kind of strength Joseph commands, that he can fill up a stadium. And there's only very special people who can do that. Joseph belongs to the world. The world look at him for inspiration.
Okay, girl. Just work hard, play hard, bowl well, and
enjoy yourself.
Enjoy yourself. Mommy and daddy support you all the way. Love you.
Hey, dear Meimei, I know that this is a very tough journey that you are on. Nobody has done it before, but you have chosen to do it. So believe in yourself. Just go as far as you can. Gampate dong sing.
I hope whatever his dreams, all that he wished for, would come true.
Well, like my wish for him is just to be happy and always to be an officer and a gentleman. Well, son, this must be the best hidden secret that I ever kept away from you. I always love you, eh? And I'm very proud of you.
Touch. I mean, like, how often do sisters do this kind of videos for their sisters, siblings?
You know, obviously very touched by that. Like my dad said, you know, we have a great relationship, which is amazing, like the things he said. And I gotta go give him a big hug after that.